In this video, you'll see a demonstration of a sample application that shows how to create a Lync contact list control and how to retrieve the URI of a selected contact. I'll begin by starting the sample, and you can see that the contacts list shows the same three contacts you see over to the right in the Lync client itself. And that if I add a contact to the Lync client, the sample application updates to include it. Then you see that if I select a contact, the contact SIP address displays in the list box. So how did the author create all this functionality? What I see in the application window is there's a left side and a right side, and the left side looks like part of the UI you see in the Lync client, while the right side of the application window is just a button and a list box for displaying a SIP address. So let's take a look at the C# code. The author didn't add too much to this file, just a click event containing a call to a contact list control and an add method for the list box. And that's not a lot of code for all the work we see happening here. The contact list control was the clue for me. What contact list control? And then I remember this is a WPF app, so there's probably some XAML code. So I find window1.xaml, open it, and there it is. And you can see three statements added to a grid control, providing for the contact list control we saw on the left side of the app window and the button and list controls on the right side of the application window. And that's all there is to provide all the functionality you saw here, a single click event in C# and a couple lines of XAML. If you want to see the full application, you can download it from the code gallery in the MSDN library, as you see here. And if you want more information generally about using contact lists and other Lync features, take a look at the Lync SDK docs in the MSDN library. You see here, there's a How Do I section, which includes, for example, this article.